So hi, welcome back to Mountain Boys. Doing another fly tying special for Drift Hook Fly Fishing today. And today, in the vise, I'm going to be tying a collared beadhead zebra midge. So you can see here I have a few different zebra midge patterns that I've tied and just some of the slight variations that you'll find on the zebra midges. What we've got here first is just a peacock collared peacock thorax with a thread head zebra midge. Now we have just a plain beadhead zebra midge. And then over here, we have the combination with beadhead and, the beadhead and the peacock hurl thorax, or the peacock collared zebra midge here. So this is the one we're gonna be tying today. To start with, I've got a size 16 Daiichi 1120. And what I like about this, especially with my midge patterns, is that it's got the continuous bend. It also helps that this is a 2x heavy, 1x short shank hook. So that'll help with our weight a little bit, getting this fly down. One thing to note, and maybe I'll go back to my flies here for a second, is that when you do the combination of peacock hurl plus a beadhead, you kind of tend to run out of space a little bit on these Daiichi 1120s. So your proportions of your abdomen here, it might start to look just a little bit stubby, but these still fish fine. I think it's more important that they have that nice bend, and if you can work in a gradual taper, moderate, you know, really, really slight taper into it, I think they work just fine. But be aware that, you know, you can also tie these on a standard hook or a sproat bend hook, and probably more of a sproat bend hook in a standard length rather than a 1x short. If you're going to go for the combination here, it might just end up stretching it out a little bit and might look better for you. But I'm here to say these work fine. So these can come in a lot of different color variations. The ones you'll probably see the most are red, black, and olive. And you can never have too many midge patterns in a bunch of sizes and a bunch of color variations in your kit. So start off with here, I'm going to do three wraps of 0.015 lead wire behind my brass bead. Go ahead and snip that off, trim it up. Now if you're using tungsten beads, you don't have to worry about this step because that tungsten bead will get that fly down quick. But since we're using a brass bead here, you have to, you know, help the fly along a little bit and give it a little bit more weight. Plus, when you get this wire smooshed down into the bead head itself, it'll help just keep it in place. So really this lead wire in here is serving a dual purpose, like I said, get that fly down and also to hold the bead head in place. So for thread on this one, I'm using 70 denier red ultra thread. I'm going to come in right behind my lead wire wrap and I'm going to start my thread wrap. A couple turns, make sure it's cinched down a little bit. Now using this ultra thread, you don't want to pop it like I normally would with unithread, because then you'll get a bunch of stray fibers that'll go everywhere. This stuff doesn't break quite as cleanly as unithread. So, I've got that in nice and secure. Now, I'm going to tie in some brassy size gold ultra wire. Now, on a size 16 like this, you can either get away with brassy size or small size ultra wire. This is kind of the intermediate size hook where, you know, both will get you by. But if you're going to be tying this in 14s, I would use brassy. And if you're going to be tying 18s, I would use small. So I'm going to go ahead and tie this in right behind that lead wire wrap. Secure it, and I'm going to keep it on top of the shank of the hook. And I'm going to make nice, consistent, even wraps to cover up all the shiny bits. And I'm going to tie this pretty far back on the hook now. I'm going to go to where we really start to make that 90 degree bend, and I'm almost tying it into the vise draws itself before I'm going to go ahead and wrap back up. And at this point, I'm going to start to cover my lead wire wrap just a little bit. Unithread lays down nice and flat, but I find it tends to be a little bit slick, and it doesn't break as nicely, like I said. And it'll, since it's slick, it'll tend to fall off occasionally. So if you're doing just the thread head variety of the zebra midge here with the peacock curl collar, you can find that your thread will just really want to fall off the front of this thing. So you'll have to be cautious of that. So once I've got this tied in where I want, I'm going to bring my thread right behind the bead head, and I'm going to counter wrap my gold wire back up. These don't need to be super tight wraps. We're just going to give the abdomen of this guy a little bit of definition and ribbing. So and this is one fly in particular. I've mentioned a few, but this is a fly in particular where a rotary vise would be handy. So once I get my wire where I want it, I'm going to make kind of a nice double wrap with the wire. I'm going to come over with my thread, and I'm actually going to go around it, and I'm going to reverse my thread around that wire right there, and that'll help hold it in place a little more. And I'm going to reverse it again, come back over the top, reverse it again, and I'm going to do that a couple times, and that really locks that wire into place so that when I go ahead and get rid of the excess here, it's not going to come undone on me and unravel. And when it's not that nice and secured, I can just go ahead and helicopter it right off. Now it's time to tie in the peacock thorax. And for that, I just have a nice peacock eye here. I'm going to choose a nice one. Doesn't need to be super thick, but I do want it to not be a chewed up one either. So when I find one I like, I'll go ahead and break it off. Might snip off that end right there. And I'm going to tie this in right behind the bead head. So once it's secure, I'll end my thread right behind the bead head, and we're just going to wrap this in. So we've got it where we want, 5 or 6 wraps with it. I'm going to catch it in a single wrap, double wrap. Now it's nice and secure. You'll find that a peacock curl can be kind of finicky to work with sometimes. It's pretty delicate. It doesn't take a lot of manhandling to break this stuff. So to get the excess off here, I'm going to come in with my scissors, and I'm not actually going to snip it. I'm going to make a little V-point, and I'm just going to press that into the excess right there, and it'll pop. So maybe give it 2 more wraps just so it's not going to come undone on us. And it's time to whip finish. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's it. So tying is complete now. I can go ahead and, again, pop off my excess thread there. And to finish it off, I'm just going to use a little bit of clear nail polish right there on that whip finish, just to hold everything in place. So there is a size 16 red and gold zebra midge with a bead head and a peacock curl thorax right there. Again, I can't stress enough that you should have a lot of different midges in a lot of different colors and a lot of different sizes in your kit. You know, if you even have a box in your kit that's just midge patterns, do it. They're super productive, super useful, and you won't regret it. So again, this is Mountain Boys doing a fly tying special for my buddy Matt over at Drift Hook Fly Fishing, and I'll see you next time.